Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews, contracting, and on-site training. In this episode, I need to do a follow-up to episode 312, which was Stop Using constexpr. Now, the key point in this particular episode is that you should be using static constexpr instead, which I still stand by, but we need to make a little bit of a addendum to this episode. So, of course, I want to remind you to check out all of the links in the video description. You can find information on how to contact me on the books that I've written and the puzzle books that I have available, as well as a link to information on how you can submit your own episode ideas. So I am trying to make this channel now largely driven by you. So we are today on static constexpr versus inline constexpr. Now the point of the episode on static constexpr is that if you've got a local value, then you want to make it static constexpr instead of just plain constexpr. If we take this completely contrived example here, then what we are actually asking the compiler to do is to put the object called value on the stack every time this function is executed. And if this is a very large object, then we're actually copying a bunch of data onto the stack for no particularly good reason, and this can result in a large performance regression. So static constexpr for a local value in a function. I still say this is your best option. And I've gone a few rounds on this now, because shortly after the last episode on this topic aired, I got someone from my local meetup who made a comment to me. Now, of course, I always recommend that you should be attending your local meetup. If you have a meetup in your area, you should attend it. There is always lots of interesting talks and things to learn, and my meetup tries to be virtual as well, so you can check that out if you want to, and that is the Denver C++ meetup. All right, so we're going to dig into the point that the person in my meetup made, and it was about static constexpr at file scope. Or more to the point, static constexpr in a header file. That is really where this is going to matter. So you can see here, I created an array of many integers, 10 million integers, and ints on every modern platform are going to be 4 bytes. Unless we're talking an 8-bit microcontroller like AVR, then they'll be 2 bytes. But we can approximate that there will be 40 million bytes of zeros stored in our object file. So let's just go ahead and do a quick compilation and linking of these things. It's probably worth actually pointing out how that header is used. So this really isn't complicated at all. I just have a function called getData that includes header.hpp. And in main, I am including this header.hpp and I am forward declaring get data. So I have some access to this data blob in both cases, and it is declared static constexpr. Let's just take a quick look at these file sizes. We can see that plus a little bit more. And we can see that main is basically the exact same size as file one. So let's go ahead and, well, we'll just compile it all at once so that you don't think that there's anything up my sleeve here. And sure enough, aout, the resulting binary, is 80 megabytes. Let's go ahead and do a quick strip of that as well. And it is still 80 megabytes. It made no difference at all. So when we have the static data at header file scope, we are getting a duplication of this data. So let's go ahead and change this now to inline. And now we'll recompile the binary. And we can see that the resulting a.out is 40 megabytes. The compiler, the linker, more to the point, merged those two blobs of data because they were marked inline. So the takeaway here, so it's worth pointing out that if you're at file scope, you're at the global scope, then these things are implicitly static anyhow. So you could say static inline constexpr if you wanted to. It should result in exactly the same thing, but let's just go ahead and verify it so that that question does not remain unanswered. Oh, don't do that. All right, so I am mistaken here. Do not declare it both static and inline, only inline. Okay, so I think that thumbs up the point that this episode needed to make. Static constexpr for constexpr values at function scope, inline constexpr for constexpr values at file scope. We want the compiler, the linker, to be able to deduplicate this data for us. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Make sure you check out all the things in the video description and be sure to subscribe.